Glad that the Commonwealth Prime Ministers have very kindly agreed to consider the Kashmir question collectively and make an effort in finding a solution of this problem. And because it is my conviction that so long as the Kashmir question is not settled, neither Pakistan nor India could be or would be in a position to play their proper role in the maintenance of peace in Asia.
14 August, Qaid Azam ki tamam umar ki koshishon ka shandar mahasil hai. Aur 11 September ko Qaid Azam मुल्क के पाकिस्तान कायम करके इस जहान फानी से रुख्सत हुए. इन्नल्लाह व इन्ना इलैहि राजिऊन. दुनिया में और मुल्क भी हैं लेकिन उनमें और पाकिस्तान में ये फर्क है कि पाकिस्तान एक मुल्क होने के अलावा एक पैगाम भी है. क़ुव्वत मुस्लिमीन का पैगाम, हुकूमत आलम का पैगाम, हुकूमत आम का पैगाम.
इट इज अ रिलीजन फॉर ऑल टाइम, परफेक्ट एंड एंड्योरिंग. टू से दैट दिस रिलीजन मस्ट रिमेन स्टैटिक एंड नॉट डायनामिक इज टू चैलेंज द इटर्नल कैरेक्टर ऑफ द रिलीजन. लाइफ मूव्स ऑन. देयर मस्ट बी डायनामिज्म इन द रिलीजन टू कीप पेस विद द मार्च ऑफ टाइम. If one were to say that one cannot ride an automobile or aircraft simply because it was not prescribed by Islam, or such modes of locomotion did not exist at the time of the Prophet, is to insult Islam. To say one must not use radio or one cannot use a loudspeaking system in the mosque for khutbah because these appliances are all devil's apparatus is again to insult Islam. All these also would imply that the all-knowing, all-seeing and all-powerful God did not visualize man's progress and what human ingenuity could fashion.
Once again, the Security Council is taking up consideration of the Kashmir dispute. Although over the course of the last 9 years, India has tried its level best to confuse world opinion with regard to this dispute, it is gratifying to note that she has not succeeded in doing so. The issue remains as simple as ever. Both India and Pakistan are pledged, and the Security Council is also a party to the solemn pledge that the question of the accession of the state will be decided through the democratic method of a free and impartial plebiscite to be conducted under the auspices of the United Nations.
In rights. The people of Gwadar have joined the people of Pakistan, and the whole of Gwadar now forms part of the Islamic Republic of Pakistan. I know that the people all over Pakistan, including those residing in Gwadar, have received this announcement with feelings of great joy. I welcome the residents of Gwadar into the Republic of Pakistan, and I would like to assure them that they will enjoy equal rights and privileges along with all other Pakistan nationals, irrespective of considerations of religion, caste or creed.
Say what sort of assistance China will give us. But as I find from the press, you see, they have said that both within and without the General Assembly, they will help the Pakistan government because they are just cause, and India is aggressor, so they will not allow the sovereignty of any country to be trampled down in that way. That is what we are.
Finally, I am not a rat. I have never ratted in my life. I faced assassination attempts. I faced imprisonments. I have always been a man of crisis. Today I am not ratting, but I am leaving your Security Council. I find it disgraceful to my person and to my country to remain here a moment longer than necessary. But I am not boycotting. impose any decision. Have a treaty worse than the Treaty of Versailles. Legalize aggression. Legalize occupation. Legalize everything that has been illegal till 14th or 15th of December 1971. I will not be a party to it. We will fight. We'll go back and fight. My country hearkens for me. Why should I waste my time here in the Security Council? I will not be a party to the ignominious surrender of part of my country. You can take your Security Council. Here you are. I'm going.
Junabe Sada, Mrs. Reagan, Khwateen-o Hazrat, Assalamu Alaikum. आपने मेरे और मेरे वतन के बारे में जिन पुरखलूस जज्बात का मेहरबानी के साथ इजहार किया है, मैं उनके लिए आपका शुक्रिया अदा करता हूँ. आपके ये कलमात दोनों कौमों के दरमियान दोस्ती के मजबूत रिश्तों को जाहिर करते हैं. आपकी मेहमान नवाजी और पाकिस्तान के इस्तेहकाम में आपकी ज़ाती दिलचस्पी हमारे लिए तकवियत और अत्मीनान का बायस है. जनाब सदर, ये आपकी क़्यादत की अकलमंदी और दूरंदेशी का नतीजा है कि दोनों मुल्कों के दरमियान तावन और इश्तराक ने एक नए वसत हासिल की है.
आपको मैं आज चैलेंज देती हूँ मिस्टर स्पीकर. क्यों डरते हैं इस चैलेंज से? कहते हैं कि हम 177 वोट्स लेकर के आए हैं, 3/4 मेजॉरिटी लेकर के आए हैं. कायदे आजम मोहम्मद अली जिन्ना को 95% मेजॉरिटी कभी नहीं मिला, हाँ लेकर के तो आए हैं. खुश हो, घोड़े को ले आओ, उसको दूध पिलाओ. घोड़े को ले आओ. When you restore order, I shall continue. All right. Thank you for restoring the order, Mr. Speaker. So, जैसे मैं आपको कह रही थी, वो घोड़ा ले आओ, जो दूध पीता है, वो घोड़ा ले आओ, जो मामलेट खाता है. वो घोड़ा ले आओ जो शहद खाता है. और बताओ कि क्या सियासतदान बुरे हैं या सियासतदानों की किरदार खुशी की गई है?
फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी एंड सेक्रीफाइस इज द की वर्ड. बोथ द कंट्रीज हैव टू बी फ्लेक्सिबल एंड बोथ कंट्रीज हैव टू सेक्रीफाइस अ फ्यू थिंग्स. द मॉडलिटीज एंड टेक्निकलिटीज I think they have to be worked out, to how it happens between India, Pakistan, and of course the Kashmiri people. You can't give them out either. So I think these are things which have to come up. And I think after 50 odd years which have passed, it's about time that everyone realizes that ultimately peace has to prevail. Humanity has to be saved. Killings have to be stopped.
We are satisfied that Pakistan and India has resumed talks. I want to assure all members of SAARC that, and indeed the world, that Pakistan is committed to pursuing peace with India. Ladies and gentlemen, I am happy to report that with the vision and the will Pakistan has under leadership of President Musharraf, we have embarked upon making meaningful efforts to resolve all differences and dispute with India, including the issue of Jammu and Kashmir.
Measures are improving by the day. New areas are being opened up. I just flew over Neelam Valley. That has a lot of work to be done there. So at the moment, we'll just be going through helicopters and giving people food and relief. In the Jhelum Valley, which I'm just going to now, and we will land there, it will open by tomorrow morning. This will be a major achievement of our engineers. They have gelled together, they have galvanized, and there's a spirit of, there's a resilience in the people. This is a terrible tragedy. It is unprecedented in the world. But people are committed to help each other, and we will proceed in this direction. And as I said, every day the facilities will get better and better.
Qualify मुझे कर ही नहीं सकता, ये हो ही नहीं सकता, आईन ही नहीं है, कानून ही नहीं है. आज आप मुझे denotify कर दें, मैं अभी चला जाता हूँ. That is up to the custodian of the house. I have to make this parliament supreme. अगर पहले किसी हेड ऑफ द स्टेट की इम्यूनिटी हटाई गई हो तो आज अगर इनकी भी हटा दें हमें परवाह नहीं है, मगर पहले डिक्टेटर्स के लिए क्यों नहीं हुआ?
कहा नुकसान पहुंचाया रियासत से बरसरे पैकार मजहबी जंगजुओं के गैर जिम्मेदाराना रवैये से इस्लाम और पाकिस्तान को नाकाबले तलाफी नुकसान पहुंचा और पहुंच रहा है. मैं बतौर वजीर आजम पाकिस्तान इन्हें हथियार फेंक कर कौमी दायरे में शामिल होने की अपील करता हूं. मैडम स्पीकर, पाकिस्तान पीपल्स पार्टी इदारों और शख्सियात का फर्क बखूबी जानती है, इसलिए हम शख्सियात की कोताहियों को इदारों के सर नहीं थोपते. हम कौमी इदारों को मजबूत करना चाहते हैं. हम इदारों के माबैन तसादम टकराव नहीं होने देंगे.
मैंने जो नौजवानों से वादे किए थे, अल्लाह ताला हमें तौफीक दे, एक एक वादा पूरा करेंगे इंशाल्लाह. एक बात का मुझे ये आप सबको भी और हम सबको भी इस बात की तकरीबन कंफर्मेशन है कि मुस्लिम लीग नून अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह इन इलेक्शंस में सबसे पार्टी बड़ी पार्टी उभर के आई है.
And but I must acknowledge the contributions that were made by General Zia, Seth Ahmed Daud, and Dr. A.Q. Khan. I still remember these are the people who anchored the contributions that were made to Al Shifa, and Al Shifa became a thriving institution. I must also thank, since 86, all the presidents, all the prime ministers, and all the military chiefs, especially the army chief, who were always supportive, all the people who held those positions, they were always very supportive of Al Shifa.
If a conventional war starts between the two countries, Mr. President, if a conventional war starts, and anything could happen, but supposing a country 7 times smaller than its neighbor is faced with the choice, either you surrender or you fight for your freedom till death, what will we do? I ask myself this question. And my belief is, la ilaha illallah, there is no God but one. And we will fight. And when a nuclear-armed country fights to the end, it will have consequences far beyond the borders.